Hi, students. Welcome to today's lecture on the course titled Entrepreneurship Development, known as EED 126. Today we're going to look at Nigerian Legal System. And the first thing we look at is the nature of law. The term law refers primarily to rules made in accordance with regulative legal rules by a determinate and effective authority, itself identified and standard constituted as an institution by legal rules for a complete community and interest by sanctions in accordance with a rule guided stipulations of adjudicative institutions. This ensemble of rules and institutions being directed to reasonably resolving any of the community's coordination problems and to rectify tolerating regulating or overriding coordination solutions from any other institution or sources of norms for the common good of the community. So these are defined by Finis 1980, page 276. So when we talk about law, just like in Nigeria, the laws, Nigerian law is being made by the lawmakers, House of Rep or House of Representative, and the Senate, and most times signed by the President. So the law is legal, and we want to look at Nigerian legal system, sources of Nigerian law, where did it originate from. So Nigerian legal system, we look at two topics: sources and classification of Nigerian law. So when we talk about sources of Nigerian law, there are five sources of Nigerian law. That is, where do these laws originate from? The first thing we have is customary and Islamic law. Then we have received English law. We have Nigerian local legislation, including delegated legislation. We have judicial precedents. Then we have law reports and we have textbooks. These are sources, or these sources are further classified into primary and secondary sources of law. Law made by Nigerian legislature form primary sources. So customary and Islamic law. Customary and Islamic law are rules and regulations recognized by the indigenous people to whom they relate as regulating their conduct in specific areas. Such area may include marriage, divorce, succession and inheritance, land and chieftaincy matters. For example, for any customary or Islamic rule to have the force of law, it must not be repugnant of the natural justice, equity and good conscience. Secondly, such rule must not be incompatible either directly or by implication with any law for the time being in force. Finally, it must be the existing native law or custom and not the native law and custom of ancient time. Customary laws must be proven of existence in any Nigerian society before non-customary courts, either through the testimony of witness who are considered vast in that area or through the use of books and manuscripts. Proof of a particular custom by evidence can be dispensed with if judicial notice has been taken of it in such circumstances stated in the Evidence Act. So you see that for customary laws, these are gotten and have been made from the custom of the people, religion. We talk about things that touches marriages or divorce, succession and inheritance. So for it to be valid, it means it must not conflict with natural justice and equity, good conscience. Secondly, such rule must be compatible with either direct or by implication with any law for the time being in force. So here we want to look at received English law. By virtue of being a British colony, English law becomes a source of Nigerian law and thus applicable in country through the mechanism of local legislation called domestication. The English law so received in the country consists of the common law of England, doctrine of equity, the statute of general application in force in England on the 1st January of 1900, then statute and subsidiary legislation on specified matters. Again, the statute may be of any general application, and yet courts may not apply it in Nigeria if convinced that local circumstances will not permit such to be enforced. This could be so if this application will produce manifestly unreasonable results contrary to the intent of the statutes. So Nigerian legislation is the next one I want to look at. Nigerian legislation refers to the law made by the legislative authority in Nigeria, the Senate and the House of Rep, both at state and federal level. Under a military regime, they are known as decrees and edicts for federal and state respectively, practiced before the return of democracy. On the other hand, under a civilian regime, federal laws are known as acts of National Assembly or acts of Parliament. The National Assembly or acts of Parliament depend on whether the system referred to is presidential or cabinet system. State laws are simply called laws, while laws made at the local government level are called bylaws. In the colonial period, they are known as ordinances. So local governments make bylaws, while states makes things that are called laws. They make laws. So these bylaws are called ordinances during the colonial era. So judicial precedent is the next thing we want to look at. The judicial precedent is the idea that the principle of law on which a court based its decision in relation to the material facts before it must be followed by a court below it in the judicial hierarchy. But a lower court can only follow a judgment of a higher court if that judgment has not been overruled by a court higher in the hierarchy of the court or by the court that gave the judgment. It follows therefore that the decision of the highest court will bind all other courts, and until changed by statute, it remains the law in respect of the matter covered. Specifically, what constitutes a precedent for later judgment is the ratio decided, in that it is the reason for the decision. Such statement made by the judge in passing or by the way in the course of delivering his judgment, and which is not strictly relevant to the issue before him, is an arbiter dictum. This has no binding effect but may be of persuasive authority, and where a decision or judgment of the court of law is arrived at by mistake or oversight of the law, such decision or judgment is said to be given by in quorum. So when we have judgment given in error, just like the one we talked about that happened in Imo State, where the Supreme Court made a judgment by in quorum. So they made a judgment which most people saw as a mistake, in error, because the facts did not reconcile, but the matter is still being contested at the moment, so it has not been laid to rest. So here we are talking about the judicial precedent, where lower court must follow the rules that have been set by the higher or apex courts. So where an apex court declares that a matter is binding, it cannot be overruled by a lower court. So the judicial precedent must be followed. So where a lower court must follow order from a higher court in judicial hierarchy. So the next thing we want to look at is law reports. Law reports is essential for the growth of case law system. There have been private government initiatives in this direction. The Nigerian Weekly Law Reports by Chief Gadifa Wemi and all the Nigerian Law Reports by the Federal Ministry of Justice, among others, are some of the well-compiled and edited series. Also our test book. Finally, on the point of law, especially where such points have not been previously decided in the court, or where the position of the law on the point is not clear, courts may turn to textbooks for notable authors for assistance and guidance, but their books are merely persuasive. The Evidence Act specifically provides, as regards customary law, that any book or manuscript organized by native as a legal authority is relevant, especially book written by seasoned legal icons. So most times We have textbooks that also serve as a means of where citation or that can be used to deliver judgments, or that can serve as law. Surely when those books have been validated and they've been used, they've been a source of credible and reliable information, then surely when they are written by seasoned legal icons, such textbooks may be used during court session, or they may be cited as part of the law. The law of Nigeria is the next thing we want to look at. The law of Nigeria consists of courts, offenses, and various types of laws. Nigeria has its own constitution, which was established on 29 May 1999, before or during the handover to democracy. The constitution of Nigeria is the supreme law of the country. There are four distinct legal systems in Nigeria, which include the English law, the common law, the customary law, and the Sharia, which is the Islamic law. English law in Nigeria is derived from colonial, we've said this already, and we've talked about customary law, we've talked about other ones, type of law. So hierarchy of Nigerian legal system. So when we talk about it, Nigerian constitution recognizes courts as either federal or state courts. The primary difference between both is that the president appoints justices, judges to federal courts, while the state governor or governors appoint judges to the state courts. All appointments, federal or state, are based on recommendation of the National Judicial Council. So, the National Judicial Council in Nigeria recommends for the president or governors for appointment. The federal courts are the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeal, and the Federal High Courts. The state courts include the High Court of the state, the Customary Court of Appeal of a state, and the Sharia Court of Appeal of a state. Each of the states, currently 36, is constitutionally allowed to have all these courts. However, the predominantly Muslim northern states tends to have Sharia courts rather than customary courts. The predominantly Christian southern state tends to have customary courts and not Sharia courts. Yes, because in Nigeria we see that the northern states, especially the Muslim areas, Kano, Kaduna, Katsina, have Sharia courts. The predominantly Christian states, like when you come to Enugu, Port Harcourt, they all have here, Imo State, are the customary court. Due to the fact that Nigerian capital, known as a happy town or the Federal Capital Territory, FCT, is not a state, it has no governor. Its courts that are equivalent to the state courts have their judges appointed by the president and are thus federal courts. The FCT courts are the High Courts of the FCT, the Customary Court of Appeal of the FCT, and the Sharia Court of the FCT. We want to look at Tier 1, which is the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court of Nigeria is the highest court in Nigeria. It is based in the capital, Abuja. The Supreme Court is mainly a court of appellate jurisdiction and is the final appeal court in the country. It also has original jurisdiction in state versus state and state versus federal government cases. The Supreme Court is headed by a Chief Justice who is assisted by other justices. The appointment of the Chief Justice and justices require confirmation by the Senate. We want to look at it at Tier 2, which is the Court of Appeal. The next highest court is the Court of Appeal in Abuja. However, to bring the administration of justice closer to the people, the Court of Appeal has multiple divisions, currently 16, in various parts of the country. The head of the Court of Appeal has the title President of the Court of Appeal. He or she is assisted by justices. Only the appointment of the President of the Appeal Court requires Senate confirmation. The Court of Appeal is mainly a court of appellate jurisdiction. However, it has original jurisdiction for president and vice presidential election petitions. The Federal Court of Appeal is where the multiple legal systems, English, customary, and Sharia of the Nigerian coverage, it is constitutionally required to have at least three judges who are versed in the customary law and at least three judges who are versed in Islamic personal law. Judgment from the courts the appeal court can be appealed to the Supreme Court, which is the tier one court. So whenever someone is not satisfied at the court of appeal, he can go to the Supreme Court. The tier three, just below the Federal Court of Appeal, are the tier three courts, and they include one, the Federal High Court, two, the High Court of the State, three, the Customary Court of Appeal of a State, and four, the Sharia Court of Appeal of a State. So the Federal High Court is based in Abuja. In order to bring the administration of justice closer to the people, it has a division in each of the 36 states of the country. The Federal High Court is generally a court of original jurisdiction. However, it has appellate jurisdiction from tribunals such as the Tax Appeal Tribunal. It is presided over by a chief judge who is assisted by other judges. The High Court of the State / that of the Federal Capital Territory is the highest English law court in the state, or the FCT. The High Court of the State and / FCT and the Federal High Court have similar powers. Due to the fact that there is a division of Federal High Court in each state and that each state has its own High Court, there is usually some confusion as to which court is which. For example, in Lagos State, there is a Federal High Court, Lagos, and a High Court of Lagos State, sometimes referred to as the Lagos State High Court. It is presided over by a chief judge who is assisted by other judges. The Customary Court of Appeal of the State / the FCT is the highest customary law court in the state, like FCT. It is presided over by a judge who has the title President of the Customary Court of Appeal of the State, like the FCT, and is assisted by other judges. The Sharia Court of Appeal of the State / FCT is the highest Sharia law court in the state / FCT. It is presided over by a Grand Qadi who is assisted by other Qadis. Judgment from these three courts can be appealed by the Federal Court or appealed to the Federal Court of Appeal. The last one I want to look at, which is the Tier 4 courts, which is the state courts, the lowest courts in the country are all state courts. There is no federal court in this group. They include the magistrate courts that handle English law, the customary court that handle customary laws, and the Sharia court that handle Sharia laws. Judgment from the Tier 4 courts can be appealed only to their respective higher Tier 3 courts. Judgment from the English law magistrate court can only be appealed to the Tier 3 English Law Courts, which is the High Court of the State / FCT. Other courts include the election tribunals. We have the Code of Conduct Tribunal. We have the Sharia Courts. So when we look at the election tribunal, this one is used for petition, the election matters, and states or legislative elections. Then we have the Code of Conduct Tribunal. This one is established by the Chapter C-15 Code of Conduct Bureau and Tribunal Act No. 1 of 1989, Laws of the Federal or Federation of Nigeria 2004, with the commencement date of 1st January 1991, which provide for the establishment of Code of Conduct Bureau and Tribunal to deal with complaints of corruption by public servants for the breaches of his provision. The Code of Conduct Tribunal (CCT) shall consist of a chairman and two other members, whose chairman shall be a person who has held or is qualified to hold office as a judge of Superior Court of Record in Nigeria, and shall receive such remuneration as may be prescribed by the law. The Sharia law, also known as Islamic law, is the law that is used only in the predominantly Muslim north of the country. Sharia, meaning way or path in the religious law of Islam, and has been in Nigeria for a long time. Civil Sharia law has been enshrined in various Nigerian constitutions since independence. The most recent constitution came into effect in 1999. With the return of the country to democratic rule in 1999, some of the predominantly Muslim modern states have instituted full Sharia law, criminal and civil. Full Sharia law was first passed into law in Zamfara in late 1999, and the law came into effect in January 2000. Since then, 11 other states have followed suit, such as Kano, Katsina, Niger, Bauchi, Borno, Kaduna, and Gombe, Sokoto, Jigawa, Yobe, and Kebbi. So, Students, this is where we come to the end of today's lecture. Thanks for being with us. See you in the next video. Bye for now.